Volcanoes form constructive and destructive plate margins when magma reaches the surface. At constructive plate margins, the plates are moving apart and magma rises up to fill the gap between them. At destructive margins, the plates are moving towards each other. The oceanic plate is subducted under the continental plate. As the oceanic plate is forced into the mantle, it melts, forming magma, which then rises up to the surface to form a volcano. There are two main types of volcano: composite volcanoes, also known as stratovolcanoes, and shield volcanoes. Composite volcanoes are formed at destructive plate margins. They have more viscous lava, which means it is more sticky and contains more silica. The volcano has steep sides and a narrow base, and alternating layers of ash and lava. They erupt infrequently, but the eruptions are very violent. Shield volcanoes are formed at constructive plate margins. They have less viscous lava, meaning it contains less silica. This lava is very runny. The volcano has gentle slopes and a wide base, with a low rounded peak. The eruptions are more frequent, but also less violent. Here is a diagram of a composite volcano, and here is a diagram of a shield volcano. Like earthquakes, volcanoes have two types of effects, primary and secondary. Primary effects are caused directly by the volcano and include deaths, damage to buildings, and ash going into the atmosphere. Secondary effects are caused by the primary effects, for example, flights being cancelled due to ash in the atmosphere. There are also two types of responses, immediate and long term. Immediate responses happen as the volcano erupts and in the immediate aftermath, such as evacuation, whereas long-term responses occur in the weeks, months, and years after the event, for example, rebuilding infrastructure.